Hey guys, this is Vincent, and in this Lightroom Classic tutorial, I'm going to show you how to find people or detect faces throughout the Lightroom catalog. So in order to do that, we would need to click on the Find Faces tool. But in my original import, I did not have any photos of people. So what I did was I downloaded a few stock photos from Pexels and Unsplash. I'll put a link to those websites. They're free stock photos. If you need something, they're a great website, and I'm not sponsored by them or anything like that, but it's great to utilize those tools or those photos for demonstration purposes. But anyways, I'm gonna go and get the photos that I have here, and these are the photos that I'm just gonna pull into the Lightroom library. It automatically opens up the import tool from my SD card here, and I'm just gonna add the new photos, and there's no reason to include subfolders because they were not in subfolders. So I'll just click on import, and you'll see here the previous import. If I go to all photographs in the catalog, it'll show everything, but right now I'm just in the previous import in the grid view of the library module. So now I'm gonna start tagging these faces or these people. Now, I'm not gonna tag them all, but I'll give you a good idea of how it works. So now I just clicked on the find people icon or the people icon, and what Lightroom does is it detects people, and then it tries to stack the people or the photos together that are similar. So for this example, there's four photos that are similar of this individual. I can click on her, click on the first photo, or I can close the stack and I'll double click, and I have to start giving them names. I already pre-populated some of this during my testing, so I'll put her as Sarah, this as Ryan, and this as Tommy. And there you go. And press enter. Now I'll go back to the grid view. Sorry, go back to the people tool. And now you can see Ryan, Sarah, and Tommy. And now what Lightroom's going to do is it's going to try to guess other photos that are Sarah, Tommy, or Ryan. Here you can see it's stacked. So in order to accept it or reject it, I can click on accept, or I can drag it as well. This is Ryan, this is Ryan, yep. And I'll drag that as well. This is Sarah. So there's three photos that identified as Sarah. So I can drag that to Sarah. And this individual is a part of Sarah's family in another group photo, but I have not named him yet. So I'll give him a name of John, which I already used. And now John is ready to go. So now I'll go back to the people tool, or you can just press O, I believe, for the shortcut. And now John is there. So you can see this person is not John. You can either accept or reject. So I'll reject him, and I'll give him a name of Rob, which I already did earlier. And that's Rob. And this is John. So I can just drag it. And now, if there's certain people, let's say for this photo right here, here's the main person I'm photographing, and let's say this individual is just in the background, and it's not someone you want to tag, you can just click on this X icon or press delete, so that person will not be a part of the Finding Faces catalog. So that's pretty much it for the Finding Faces. It's pretty easy, it's pretty straightforward, and while you're in your Lightroom catalog or right here, and let's go to the grid view. Here are all the photos. You can easily find people throughout your library by going to the text, going to either keywords, but you can usually just put any searchable field. And let's say I want to go find Tommy. So here's one photo of Tommy. And if I want to go, I can also go with Ryan. Here are the photos of Ryan. And if I don't want to do this and get out of the filter bar, I can just click on this people tool again, and here I have all the people. This is a great tool if you want to send prints or find people and then edit and send prints to your clients. It's especially great for, let's say, a wedding photographer that wants to find all the photos of the wedding party, including the bride and groom. It's pretty good. It's not something I usually do or use, the people tool, but it's there if you need it. And if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe, like, and follow me on Instagram. Have a good one.